Chapter 18. I took full advantage of the situation. Here's my current situation. Career-wise, my babies are still the most precious things in my life. However, it seemed assisting them with love and relationships only opened a trick bag of more problems. Still, I serve as their coolest mentor and their auntie bae forever. What else? Well, the Most High took my mama and daddy from me at the same dang time. How cruel was that? Hell, I'm Esther Bay. It was not fair. I started to consider whether I was cursed to live out my remaining days as a random. I thought so, then Thomas showed up. That man of God genuinely cared for me. Plus, it had been a long time since any man had made me feel that way. Did I mention I'm a solar Libra with a Venus in Cancer? That might not mean a lot to you, but those in the know, no. It simply means that my intuition is keen and allows me to see what kind of whirlwind I had caused in the Pastor Thomas' home. The fact that he sparsely returned my texts and never returned my calls unless he was on church grounds let me know the proverbial poo-poo had hit the fan. And so what? What else am I supposed to hold on to? The past 48 hours for the good Reverend Doctor had been crappy at best. His wife Joy had been deeply hurt by his recent actions and is starting to question whether she could ever trust him again. Finally, the time had come for both to make some tough decisions. The pastor must decide on being faithful to his flock, mainly me, or allow peace to reign in his home. It was 4:30 p.m., one half hour away from his next counseling session with Esther Bay. As usual, he eased out of the lazy boy chair, laid out his clothes on the bed, and headed for the shower. Immediately, Joy jumped up too, laid out her clothes too, and hopped in the shower right after he finished up. As he dressed, she dressed too. When he left, heading towards the church, she followed behind him in her luxury vehicle. Still, they hadn't said one word to one another. He pulled into the pastor's parking space. She pulled into the spot for the first lady right next to his. He entered the sanctuary, strolled into his office, shut the door behind him. The first lady walked in right behind him, yet chose to sit in the waiting area of the office to chat with the secretary. Joy craftily acted as if nothing at all was going on between her and the pastor. About 15 minutes or so before our session, I sounded the bell from outside the door. The secretary checked the monitor and buzzed me in. Knowing what I was facing, I took full advantage of the situation and wore a skin-tight blue denim cat suit with brown pumps and a brown Louis Vuitton bag. I had a long ponytail that sat atop my perfectly round donk. Indeed, I strolled into the church's office with the confidence of a runway model at a high-class fashion show. My hips swayed back and forth as if they were in perfect accord with my flat waistline, making a circular motion with every step I took. "Hey, Miss Pearl, I'm here for my weekly appointment," I said fervently, staring into the glaring eyes of the First Lady. Just then, Joy leaned back in her seat and crossed her legs, I guess to let me know my antics weren't moving her at all. Silently, yet taking in every word, Miss Pearl kept her secretary duties going while watching this charade take place. "Pastor," she said, "Miss Bay is here." "Very good, very good. I'll be right there," he replied. He quickly opened his door and attempted to greet her in a respectable fashion, but he couldn't get out a word. "Hello, Miss Bay," he said, stuttering. I replied, "Hello, Thomas." "Excuse me, Madam First Lady," I nodded, waltzing right past her and right into her husband's office. Though he tried to remain tactful, he couldn't help but stare at my ample rear as I moved slowly toward the visitor's chairs in his office. Once he realized he was totally mesmerized and in a deep, deep stare, he stupidly gathered himself, smiled, then turned toward his wife and promptly slammed the door shut. Wham! After 45 minutes or so, Thomas was trying his best to listen to my concerns, but I made sure bubbling boobs were staring back at him. "Pastor, I'm starting to feel really vulnerable. I need someone or something to hold, touch, and comfort me during this time," I revealed. "I lie in bed at night yearning for something that. "Yes, okay, can you explain the that?" he said, sliding up in his seat. I don't know exactly what it is, Pastor. I figure you could offer some suggestions as to what or whom I need in my life, because I think we know the why. And then how to make this deep emptiness go away, I begged, tears welling up in my eyes. Sister Esther, he said, looking exasperated from dealing with his divine duty and his lust. We will find a solution soon enough, I think. The point is to keep seeking that divine way that will bring healing and wholeness. At that moment, I stood to my feet and started to parade through the office, trying to further explain my emptiness. While I walked, I slapped my thighs and butt at the time. Hold on. While I walked, I slapped my thighs and butt at times to emphasize my point. I posted my hand on my hips, sashaying from side to side. Then I finally walked over to him and sat on the desk while rubbing my feet against his leg. Sister Bade, Pastor said, I think it would be wise if you would move back to the other side of the desk. Knock, knock, knock. The First Lady Joy had had enough. She'd been as patient as she possibly could, and now it was time to get him and her straight. The pastor opened the door. How long is this session anyway? The First Lady said selfishly. Pastor Thomas slammed the door in her face again without saying a word. Thomas! Thomas! Open this door! She screamed, before realizing how embarrassing her actions had become. She summoned her dignity and walked away. Miss Pearl, the faithful secretary, was steadily taking notes and texting the word out as it was happening. After Pastor and I parted ways, she stayed in the office for hours. I left unfulfilled, yet happy that I had exploited the First Lady with my petty antics. Little did we know that the past hour would shape the four of our lives drastically in the coming months. For one, Pastor Thomas was heralded as a weak, unfaithful man, yet a great and faithful servant of the white Jesus that hung above his office desk. Two, his wife became known as a bona fide ride or die wife who was ready to scrap for her husband because he wouldn't put his hoe in check. Three, Miss Pearl became Monument City's new Wendy Williams, commanding all the latest hot, juicy topics from the fornicating, drunken, LGBT community-supported activities going on in the sanctuary. And bringing up the rear, me. You know, the woman who just buried her mother and father by herself without the emotional support of any living relatives. I became the pastor's prostitute and the so-called whore of Zion Methodist Church. All because my actions in the office that day were not only heard, but viewed on the camera that sits under Miss Pearl's desk. So she and the First Lady saw and heard every word that was going on. Consequently, I left the church shortly afterwards without resolving any of her issues.